human, and there is something a little bit uncomfortable about a world where fakes can fool, especially when they're not just mimicking music, but people. To explain, let's welcome Dr. Alex Adam. Now, Alex, you work in an area called deepfakes, right?
That's right.
So, what are they?
So deepfake algorithms are a special kind of machine learning algorithm that can take, say, one person's face or their head or their entire body or their voice and turn it into another person's head.
So to make people look like they've done stuff in videos that they've never done.
Absolutely.
Okay. I mean, that's quite something, right?
Yeah, it's quite scary. You can essentially puppet people.
So how does it work?
So you imagine if I have a video of you and a video of me. So we take those two videos and we split them up into their sort of individual frames, so the images that make up that video. And we'll show a computer all of those different images of me and you. And what the algorithms will start to learn is they'll start to learn things like what's the structure of our different faces and what are the different kinds of expressions that we make. But critically, they learn how to distinguish the two. So one of them will know, okay, I can make red hair and a particular kind of skin tone. Another one will say I can make brown hair and a particular kind of skin tone. But they'll separate out our expressions. So I'll be able to say, okay, I want to take you smiling and put that smile onto me.
So you're spitting out what your face looks like and what your face is doing.
That's exactly
right. And then you can put what your face is doing on my face.
Whilst keeping all of your other features the same.
Okay, all right. Exactly, so right. So we've got a couple of puzzles here. So here's a picture of you then. You're doing a little snarl.
Snarl.
I like that a lot. A little bit of an eyebrow raise as well. Okay, so you can make me do this face.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
How do you do it?
So if we just flip that over, so what we can think of is we can think of my expression as having some kind of abstract mathematical representation, which I'm sort of thinking of as these puzzle pieces. And what I can do is I can say, well, piece 32 and say 37 over there correspond to me making this snarl. And what I can do is I can just take those pieces, let's imagine I've got them over here, and I can just slot them in over here into your face.
So you're shuffling my face around, essentially.
Yeah, I'm basically just saying, turn on the bits of your face that will make you make that snarl.
Okay,
great.
So once you've completed that jigsaw, if you can flip it over, the idea is that... Ah, there we go. That's a lovely snarly face, isn't it?
Exactly. We'll now get Hannah with a snarl.
are there concerns about this kind of technology?
So, my day job is I'm a data scientist at faculty, and I work on using artificial intelligence techniques to sort of detect these kind of video manipulations. Obviously, there's lots of implications for the fact that you can just puppet people. I could record a video of myself saying something and just transform it into some celebrity, for example. And this has implications for, say, privacy, but also for, say, democracy and political disinformation. So there are lots of sort of concerns about that, which is why it's important to be able to detect this kind of content online. There are also many great applications, though, like dubbing, special effects, and things like that.
Do you have any top tips for spotting deepfakes?
Yeah, so I think my top tip for sort of spotting deepfakes is always just, if you're watching a video of something and you sort of suspect that it might be a deepfake, just ask the question, do you really believe that this person would do or say these things that the video is portraying? So that's like my number one suggestion. My second suggestion would be sort of do some fact checking, sort of try to see if you can find that video on some trusted news outlets, particularly if you found it posted on social media or something that's sort of harder to verify. And from a technical perspective, I think it's useful to look for things like objects in the background of the video. So if, as I move, you notice objects in the background of the video moving with me, that's a pretty strong indication that the video is being manipulated.
That, I think, is some excellent tips that will only serve us well in the future. Alex, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Now, we really want to...